Did you hear that? Drink your tea. That's the rufous-sided towhee. Then that one's going weep, dreep, dreep, dreep. That's the great crested flycatcher. That was the common yellow throat, witchity, 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 or itchity, witch, itchity, witch, itchity, witch. Everything on this side of the platform was all cranberry fields up until about 2002. We got money from the U.S. Department of Agriculture, Natural Resources Conservation Service to take the cranberry fields and put them back to wetlands. Buried underneath the flat, compacted surface of the cranberry field were the original wetland soils that had been covered up. We knew the seeds that had been buried 50 years ago would simply come back. And that's exactly what happened. The most impressive thing are the reptiles and amphibians. It's a reptile, it's a northern pine snake. The Pine Lands Commission is doing a gigantic study of pine snakes, king snakes, and corn snakes, and box turtles with radio tracking. You know, they're radio tracking dozens of animals and in order to learn more about all the different habitat needs so they can better regulate development and make sure that we don't make mistakes when it comes to protecting these species. It's way over there. All around the world, you find insect-eating plants in these acid bogs. Because of the acid, there's very low nutrients, and so they supplement their diet by eating insects. There's a close pitcher plant flower there. I could probably... So the leaves of the pitcher plant are here, and I can see a bunch of dead insects in there. They get stuck. They can't climb out. And then the plant secretes digestive enzymes and absorbs the nutrients. This is just the flower of the plant here. They're pollinated by bumblebees. This peat bog has been collecting here, you know, for 10,000 years. There are over 20 different species of sphagnum moss out there, and when they die, they just sink to the bottom and they form peat moss. It's probably 8 feet thick. 2 centuries of fire suppression and centuries of charcoaling and timbering and agriculture, they've gotten rid of, they've made everything flat. Now this is a bumpy natural landscape again where you have heterogeneity and you can have a savanna with trees. That would have been a very natural condition here that the colonists obliterated. So this is actually the recreation of an incredibly rare habitat because of the fact that we went here and dug it up.